Oh shit, I broke a stick. And I shot Satan. Shot him right in the fucking heart. Look, and I made a fucking pipe out of his antler. Out of his horn. Just like that movie. What's that movie called? The Pick of Destiny? That movie's awesome shit, man. I fucking love that movie. Jack Black is funny as shit. I fucking love Jack Black. Now, wake up in the morning! So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna take my tobacco. It come from Mother Earth. I'm gonna quit tobacco soon though, y'all, don't worry. And I'm gonna take this tobacco, I'm gonna put it in Satan's horn. There you go, fuck you, Satan. That's what I say, fuck Satan, he a bitch. Fuck Satan. Now, all right, pack it in there good. And then we finna communicate and pray with the Mother Earth by smoking this here tobacco through Satan's horn. Cause fuck Satan. He an asshole, man. Fuck the bullshit. Now, here's my pipe, made from Satan's horn. Simple as that. Look, it came from bamboo. Yeah, bamboo is fucking amazing. I love bamboo, dude. You can transform bamboo into pipes. Yeah, and that's exactly what they did. I mean, we could flow water through this. I've flown water through bamboo pipes. It's fucking fine. Check this out. This is how you do this, y'all. I like Offspring, too. We were going through the mountains in my fucking truck, and I was like, if I ain't got no brakes, we're all gonna fucking die. And it could have happened at any moment. You never know if your brakes are gonna go out or not. But this tastes good. Honey, you wanna hit this?
Yeah.
Trade places. All right, now you're Captain Planet. Queen of Africa, Captain Planet, what should we do? Are there any problems in the world that need to be fixed? No problem?
I don't know.
You don't know?
There shouldn't be any problems in the world we have to fix because we can't fix them ourselves.
We gotta try.
That's up to everybody else.
We can try though.
We can try, but what's the worth of a try?
Everything. Everything.
Are people gonna appreciate it?
It don't matter.
It don't matter.
It don't matter if they appreciate it or not. Hey, you gotta help her out sometimes because the wind be coming. The wind, the Holy Spirit. Maybe it ain't the Holy Spirit, I don't know. Intermittent wind. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. I don't know. You tell me. Hey, did Jesus... Question of the ages. Did Jesus die on the cross and he remained dead? And his apostles, you know, pretended and stole his body out of the thing and pretended like he rose from the dead? Or did Jesus... They moved the tomb?
Remember the next day the tomb was moved?
No.
And they said that the third day the tomb was moved and his body was gone.
Yeah, but...
Somebody came back and opened it and took his body and then pretended to be him. What if that happened?
Yeah, or did Jesus rise from the dead and he just karate kicked that door wide open because he's a fucking badass? Huh?
And holes through all his hands and cuts all up here?
Yeah, but he's Jesus though. He can do whatever the fuck he want to do.
He had a whole spear through his side.
That don't matter.
Did you remember that?
No, I didn't remember. He speared him? That's horrible.
Yeah, he had a spear through his side.
Aww.
He had a hole, like they just into the side. It was just like that. And then they...
Humans are fucking assholes, man.
They nailed him up.
Why are humans so cruel to each other?
Nailed him up and everything.
That's so horrible.
And then they laid him down.
Yeah.
And put the tomb. They rolled it.
Yeah.
Rolled it to the door. It's impossible to move it unless he had the power to knock it down. But they said it was to the side, like somebody rolled it back out. So
maybe he asked the Holy Spirit to come, the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost came and moved the tomb out of the way for him. And he just flew out of there like Neo did in the movie. Just
maybe.
Maybe. Or maybe it don't fucking matter.
It doesn't.
It doesn't fucking matter, I don't think. All that matters is what he tried to teach us.
Teaches that the miracles can happen. There's people out here
in
hospitals now that die are pronounced dead and they wake up minutes later.
I believe that.
Later.
Yeah, yes.
Later.
Absolutely. But dude, my nephew died. My nephew died. Noah. His name is Noah.
He died in the hospital. They had the fucking chaplain in there and everything. And they had all like 15 doctor, or not doctors, but they had a handful of doctors. They had the ECMO machine set up. The ECMO machine. The ECMO machine takes over your entire like cardiovascular system. So instead of, because he was fucking dead basically, but they were going to try to save his life with the ECMO machine. God bless those people at Emory University Hospital, man. Those people come from God. That place is off the chain. I love that place. There are such great people there. They saved my nephew's life. They saved his life.
Tobacco might be going.
No, there's still a tobacco hit. I'll show you how you do this. Don't be wasting it. There's still some in there. I'll smoke out of Satan's horn. Fuck a Satan. That's what I say. Fuck him. Look. Hold on. By the way, I got my New Testament Bible. This is my Jesus Bible. It's got my name on it. Captain Planet. You read it. Captain Planet. And I'm following the law. I'm following the law. I'm being respectful. I got my lifetime license. My dad gave me his, but if a cop stops us, hopefully he'll let us go. I'll show him my Jesus Bible. I'll keep it in the same pocket, and we'll be brothers. That's what I believe. I believe everybody my brother. And if I believe everybody my brother, everybody will be my brother. And look at this. I got my other Bible here. Look at this. Check that out. Yeah. Yeah, bitch. Watch yourself. Watch out. This. Also, we got the Old Testament. This one got the Old Testament and the New Testament. Just the New Testament. Now I got this one. And this, when you carry them both, they give you magical powers. Now I can see the spirit world. And you gotta watch out. There's demons and shit flying around everywhere. That shit's fucking crazy, dude. Let me hit this. Hold on. Oh, I meant to bring my seashell out here. I was gonna make a point with my seashell. It's alright, I'll communicate without seashell. But if you ever wanna know what God sounds like, you wanna hear the voice of God and the voice of the Mother Earth, take a conch seashell and put it up to your ear. Take a conch seashell and put it up to your ear, and you will hear the music of the divine. It sounds like this. That's what it sounds like. So, but I don't need it. I just cut my, you can cup your hand over your ear too, and that's beautiful sounds, man. But also, I don't know, how many more people you think the Mother Earth is gonna kill before she lets the COVID go away? Do you have any thoughts on that?
Mother Earth is gonna kill maybe another 100,000 before this COVID goes away because it's spreading so rapidly.
Yeah. It is.
Mother Nature just cleaned up the planet for like a couple million people.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying Mother Nature did it. Like, that's good.
Yeah,
but
it is what it is. I don't have control of that shit. I'm just some fucking guy. We can't control that shit. I don't know where it comes from.
Overpopulation may be the issue.
I think so. That's what it said on the Georgia Guidestones.
Overpopulation.
It said maintain humanity of 500 million. And perpetual balance from nature. That's what the Georgia guys.
People out here having babies out of woodlock without going to the hospital. So there's plenty and hundreds and thousands and millions of people that ain't got no social security number just living here.
Really?
Yeah.
Like illegal?
People do have babies without, and they raise them without taking them to a hospital and everything. And they raise them, and they never know what a hospital is. Some of them don't even know what a school is because they keep them out of everything. But they can. But the only thing they can do is when they turn 18 is maybe go to work, but with a fake ID. But some of them ain't got no profile. A lot of them don't. Imagine the village people that's living in the village,
yeah,
in the jungles and whatnot. They out here having babies naturally, like back in the day with the Indians,
yeah,
and raising them in their little
tribes. Well, can they go and register to vote and stuff? And they be like,
I mean,
hey,
if they want to become a citizen, they can go and say, hey, I've been lost. Or either I'm coming to earn my citizenship,
yeah,
and I need help.
Yeah.
Ask a social worker or something. Some of them can do that, but then they call it illegal aliens, and they're not just Hispanics.
Yeah,
there are a lot of different races. Even the Africans coming over here with different IDs. Like I think Africans actually come over here to the United States with an ID and come for 6 months and experience Americans, and then go back home and give their ID to somebody that look like them because they kind of do. A lot of them look alike.
Okay.
Especially in Africa, you know, they keep the shaved heads and all that. A lot of them are, you know, dark complexion, light complexion. It doesn't matter. But I think some of them, I think they'd be switching out with their cousins and family members just so they can experience America.
I think that they look different, but
just so they can experience America.
They do look different, but I'm just saying that's not a racist comment.
That's an
I'm just saying
racist joke, anybody that they all look the same.
Anybody
that's
can show anybody
joke.
Can yeah, show anybody can show an ID and look and then just say that, oh yeah, that's when I had my hair cut, or that's when I had my hair colored, or that's in the summertime when I had a tan or something. Anybody can use an ID. I didn't mean it
and
like
pretend,
that.
And they pretend that they're somebody else?
I didn't mean it.
Can I pretend that I'm Jesus? Is that possible?
Yeah, I didn't mean it like that. What I meant like
can
like
I pretend
say,
I'm Jesus?
Say some twin. There's some a couple of twins.
Yes, ma'am.
One twin come to the United States for 6 months. And they go back and they give their ID to their cousin or their twin sisters or whatever, or twin brother, you know, cousin, whatever. And then they use the ID to come and experience America for 6 months. Like the Amish people. There's some Amish people out here that aren't allowed to go anywhere. And the kids find a way to get out of that Amish. So they switch out with people.
I love the Amish people, dude.
Yeah.
People cool
she's like, hey,
shit.
She looks just like me.
I
like,
love.
Could you replace me for 6 months so I can experience...
Yeah.
Real college life, and so I can experience a mall and all that. So they'll sneak away. The
Are you
Amish people,
serious, the
Amish
mall?
People will sneak away into the into society
Fuck
and then
mall,
come
dude.
Back with candy or something and get in trouble.
Fuck a mall. We go to Walmart and the thrift stores, dude. And the thrift stores. I like thrift stores.
Thrift stores, Goodwills.
I love it. Yeah.
That's the mall.
That is, and there's so many good stuff in there. Used clothes and shit, man. There's so much good stuff.
It don't
there.
Matter that it's used to me. What it matters is it's single. It's just single. One item that you haven't seen in years or something that looks brand new that somebody
Unique.
Made. And you
Unique.
Get it. Unique vintage.
Vintage. Vintage.
Vintage.
Yeah. But Native Americans were so creative. And they used every part of the animal. So like the deer antler, for example. I'm going deer antler mode. This isn't Satan no more. It's just a deer. But it's probably possessed by Satan, so I fucking shot him with my bow and arrow. Fuck that asshole. So, here we go. We got the deer antler. And the bamboo. And they make this out the leather. And the Native Americans were good. They tried to use every part of the animal. They were so grateful for what they had. They were so grateful for what they had. And they tried to show respect. They tried to show respect by using every part of the animal. I went to Peru, and the culture in Peru is that whenever you take a piece of fruit off the tree, because the Mother Earth provides food everywhere, it's free. It's free. All you got to do is be grateful for it and eat it. Look, there are muscadine vines under my feet right now. This right here is muscadine. Muscadine grapes, dude.
Those are grapes?
Those are muscadine grapes.
So grapes
vines.
Actually grow out here?
Yeah.
Oh, the animals eat them all.
Yeah.
This is just an open field. There's plenty
no,
of little...
No, the animals don't eat them all. What the animals do, and what we need to start to learn from the animals...
Hibernate.
Like what deer do, they go and they nibble at a couple of the berries, and they move on to the next bush, and nibble at a couple of the berries, and move on to the next bush. They don't eat the whole thing.
Duh.
Humans take air last
humans
bit.
Humans pick to the tree gone.
Indeed. And the deer, they leave a little bit left. So in that way, the deer sustain themselves. But also the deer let the plants reproduce because they don't eat all of the fruit. They leave some of the fruit on the tree so that it can plant again and renew, and that their offspring will then have food to eat. That's very wise. Very wise. We need to be learning from the deer, y'all. We need to be learning from every source of information that's out there. I talked to these guys that were digging ditches outside my buddy's house. They were cool as shit. The crew of black dudes. And I hung out with them and drank some, well, I drank the beers. They didn't drink any beers. They were being good. But they were telling me, he was a wise man. Man in the ditch, digging in the hole. He was 10 feet in the ground. And he said, it's good when you can learn from an 8-year-old. It's good when you can learn from an 8-year-old. Kids are smart, y'all. And let me see if I can get in contact with Mother Earth. Let me hit this one more time. And I got a message for all the climate change deniers out there. You know what they say about you can't teach... An old dog, new tricks. That's kind of true for a lot of people. What we need to try to get out of, you need to try to get out of that mindset and teach an old, and try to break free of that and pretend for a minute that you're a kid again and pretend that you can learn a new trick. Entertain the possibility that you could be wrong. I could be totally wrong about climate change, but I doubt it. I think it's illogical to think that you can fundamentally change the chemistries of the atmospheres and oceans and expect there to be no ecological effects. That seems to be insane. Why? I just pump as much carbon as I want to into the atmosphere and oh, it will just whatever, it's fine. It's fine. God gave us a planet. Rape the planet all you want. It's our dominion. Blah, blah. It'll be fine. Y'all dumb as shit. Dumb as fucking shit, man. That's what I say. So hold on. Let me hit this and let me get it. I got a message for the climate change deniers out there. Mom, what'd you say? Message to the climate change deniers? Yeah, I can translate that. That's what the Mother Earth said to the climate change deniers. Mom, what'd you think about the environmentalists out there trying to do, you know, ecosystem restorations and stuff? Yeah, the environmentalists. Yeah, like Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks is awesome as shit, by the way. I'm biased. Yeah, I know. Hold on. I need to get more. Let me get closer to the dirt. Let me rub my shoes on the dirt, and I get closer to the Mother Earth. All right, Mom. Say that again. Message to the environmentalists out there. Yes, ma'am. I can translate that. Okay. To the environmentalists. Rock and roll. Rock and roll environmentalists out there. Climate change deniers, fuck you. People who are raping the planet, fuck you. We need to be taking environmental control devices seriously instead of just, oh, it's just a regulation. Whatever, let's cut the corners. We need to be taking that shit seriously, man. And the way we manage our money and monetary systems gets in the way of us being able to love the Mother Earth. And that's a problem, big problem. Queen Kiana, you got anything else you want to say?
Not at all.
All right. I went to school to be a chemical engineer because I wanted to help people. I thought that making medicine would be helping people. So I went to school to be a chemical engineer and did the pharmaceutical classes and went to Puerto Rico and toured all the pharmaceutical sites and how to make medicine and all this stuff. And one thing that I learned from those experiences and the classes, which really stood out to me, which was just baffled me completely, horrible, was quite often when you make chemicals, carry out the chemical reaction, it's not uncommon that you will make, they're called isomers. They're mirror images of themselves. So if you can imagine a molecule with all of the constituent atoms in there arranged in a geometric space a certain way, and it looks like, say, my hand, a left hand, quite often you carry out the chemical reaction, you make not only this version of the molecule, you make what's called an isomer of that molecule. The right hand. You make the right hand and you make the left hand. The way it's arranged in the atoms in space, it's a mirror image. Mirror image. You quite often make them both. And usually it's a 50-50 mix. Sometimes not, but usually a 50-50 mix of, say, the L isomer and the D isomer. L isomer, D isomer. For levo and for dextro. Like left and right, I think is what that is. L and D, quite often the isomers. And this is what I learned from the class. And this is where man's laws fucking conflict with God's laws. So you make carry out the chemical reaction. And you end up with a 50-50 mix of L and D. And you know, through your science, that only the L isomer is biologically active, okay? It's only the L isomer that's responsible for the therapeutic effect. But what you do is you patent this new drug, and you just leave it as a 50-50 mix. You leave it with the L and the D, and you feed them both. You give the patient both of them. You give them the L and the D. It's a patented drug, and you get to charge a shitload of money for it, okay? Now, After the patent expires, what they do is, they take the extra effort to go ahead and separate the L and the D isomer in a chemical process. You separate it, and then you patent just the L isomer, just the one you know that's biologically active. And you patent that, and then you get a new drug, and you're like, oh, this is the new blood pressure drug. It's better than the old one, y'all. And then you patent that, and you get to sell it at a motherfucking high price, too, for many years. So you got these patent laws that people are... they're using the patent laws, which our love of money is the reason for this. Because men love money, and their job as a CEO is to maximize return for the shareholder. which is not necessarily the same as maximizing the health of the patient. Because you know, the more fucking foreign substances you put in your body, the higher the risk level. We could have just purified it from the get-go and given the patient just the chemical that we know exhibits the therapeutic effect. Who knows what the other isomer does? They say it's benign. I'll just pass it through the system. It's fine. Who knows? It may fucking cause cancer for all I know. I don't know. 20 minutes. But that's the problem. I'm 20 minutes long? All right. I'll shut up. But that's why I went to school, and that's what I learned from, and it was just sad to learn that stuff, man. It's sad. And then I went and worked at chemical plants, and I raped the planet and polluted the environment. I'm sorry. But I'm trying to change my ways. That's why I'm doing solar panels now. I should have been an electrical engineer, but I was a chemical engineer wanting to make medicine. But then the pharmaceutical industries are full of shit, so fuck them. Fuck them. We're doing solar panels now, y'all. Renewable energy, solar panels, that's the future. We got to make a better future for the children. Got to make a better future for the children. And I love you all. Captain Planet, out.